Okay, so let's talk about solving quadratics through the quadratic formula. And up until this point, we've been kind of pigeonholed into we must factor, so it had to be factorable. Or we were going to use the square root method, which means we had to isolate the square. Now we're going to be in a situation where we can find the zeros of the roots of a quadratic, any quadratic, by use of this process. So that's kind of nice. Let's look and see what it looks like. Okay, so here's the formula. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, and you got all these variables, and we're going to be using this form right here where the number in front of our x squared is a, our middle term, constant in front of our middle term is going to be b, and the constant at the end that technically has an x to the zero. Of course, we'd never see that, but that would be our c, okay? So let's look at a few examples and see how this works itself out. Okay, so solve for the zeros using the quadratic formula. We have, in this case, a is 1, b is 3, and c is a positive 1. Okay, so let's just write it. So we have x equals negative, and even know that this is not negative, I still put parentheses out of habit, negative b, just in case it was a negative, I wouldn't mess that up. So negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared, same thing, I always put the b in parentheses just in case it's negative, minus 4 a c, and that is over 2a. And try not to do too much at once, so I'm going to do this in a few steps. I've got a negative 3, and forget the parentheses, plus and minus, and simplify this out a little bit. I got 9 minus 4 over 2. And let's see where we're at here. So now we have negative 3 plus and minus, and this is the square root of 5 over 2. And the only thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to check two things. I'm going to see if this radical is reducible. It's not. This 5 is a prime number, so we can't factor the square root of 5. And I'm also going to look at the 2 to see if it was divisible here and here. And the rule is generally if you can divide into this number and this number, you should reduce it, you reduce those fractions. If it's not divisible into both, in this case there's a 1 that lives right there, you can just leave the answer as is. Some, this is in your textbook, for instance, you may see the answer listed as follows. Because remember, this is telling me that I have a negative 3 plus root 5 over 2 and a negative 3 minus root 5 over 2. So you might see it written this way in a textbook, separating the zeros. But the plus and minus is fine for my class, so that's okay. So there we are. There's the quadratic formula. It was not reducible in the end. We can just circle it and move on. If you put this in a calculator, it'll give you the decimal equivalents of where this thing is crossing the x-axis, or at least where that is crossing the x-axis. Okay, so let's look at a couple more examples. So now we've got a formula here that we're going to utilize, but again, the first thing we might want to do is identify our a, our b, oops, I'm talking right, and our c, which in this case happens to be negative. Okay, so here we go. X equals negative b. And you notice I wrote that negative before I even look. Just in case it's negative, I don't mess that up. Plus and minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac. That is over 2 times a. Okay, and same thing. I'm just gonna try not do too much at once. So I'm just gonna bring in my negative 7 plus or minus, and I'll clean this radical up a little bit. So this is 7 squared. There's 49. And here's a negative times a negative. And that's oftentimes I see people make a mistake there. Even though this negative sitting out here, if you multiplied all this together and brought it here, you're gonna get a plus. And this is 8 times 4, which is 32. And that's over 4. So what is that? Negative 7 plus or minus 81. That is the square root of 81 over 4, which is reducible. So we'll make that plus or minus 9 over 4. And of course, we can't leave the answer like that because there's some math to do. I have negative 7 plus 9 divided by 4 and negative 7 minus 9 divided by 4. So let's do those right here. Let's do the plus first. What's that going to give us? Well, negative 7 plus 9 is 2, and 2 over 4 is 1 half. There's the first zero. Now let's do the minus. Negative 7 minus 9 over 4. And what's that? Negative 7 minus 9 is negative 16. Negative 16 divided by 4 is negative 4. And there's the second zero. This thing crosses the x-axis twice. It's going to cross at 1 half and negative 4. Okay? So we could finish the problem. It wasn't left irrational or imaginary. So we want to close the deal. Okay, two more examples. Okay, just working through the same process. Let's identify A. A is 4. B is 5. And C is 6. So what do we got? X equals negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4, A, C, over 2A. So there's negative 5 plus or minus, and let's clean this up a little bit. That's 25. This is negative 16 times 6, it's 96, and that's 8. Okay, one step left to get a better look at what we have. What is this? 25 minus 96 is negative 71, and that's over 8. So there's a couple things we've got to do here. Actually, there's only one thing we've got to do here. We've got to reduce this. So let's do that over here. Square root of negative 71 is the same as the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 71. And the 71's prime, so I know I can't reduce that. But I know the square root of negative 1 is I. So I'll just connect these two like that. And some people get confused on where to put the imaginary. If there is no other, if there's a number that's not other than 1, for instance, there's just a 1 there, you're supposed to technically put it on the end. If there would have been a number other than 1, you're supposed to kind of squeeze it in between. So that's really where that's going to live. So in this answer is going to be right here at negative 5 plus and minus the square root of 71i over 8. And it's a little tricky to put it right there because you want to make sure that your radical stops and then you're putting the imaginary on the outside so it doesn't look like it's inside there. But there's the answer. And again, all that's really telling me right now is that this quadratic, it just doesn't cross the x-axis at all. There would be two imaginary zeros, okay? And again, that's a great way of thinking about it. This is not a real number, which means it doesn't really cross the x-axis, okay? All right. And see what we can do, and do this all by your lonesome. See what you come up with. Okay, let's see here. What do we got? We got A is 2, B is negative, so we're gonna have B is negative 4, and C is 5. So X equals negative B. This is why I do that. I write a negative and then I look, it's negative, plus or minus the square root. Again, why I put parentheses here, because I'm squaring a negative, so there's b squared, minus 4ac, and that whole thing is over 2a. I see in class a lot where somebody will get the wrong answer, they're going to get errors, they get things like that, and oftentimes it's because they're messing up in the calculator. So this is why I keep saying not to do too much at once, just step by step. Negative negative is positive. Let's clean this up a little bit. Negative 4 squared is 16. This is minus 40. That's over 4. And let's clean this up just a little bit. So 4 plus or minus the square root of negative 24. Over 4. So I do see this 4 and this 4. I'm going to be able to reduce that, and I have to reduce that. So let's go over here and do that. So the square root negative 24 is equal to the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 24. And let's reduce the square root of 24. 2 and 12, 2 and 6. Now, technically, I can make the 6 a 2 and a 3, right? Remember, prime factorization is looking for pairs. I have a pair of 2s, which means I can take one out. I already have an I that lives on the outside, so I know I'm going to multiply those together. And what's left? Well, this I have a 2 and a 3 I couldn't pair up, so technically I have a 6 left in. So the root negative 24 is going to reduce to 2i root 6. Okay? Now I'll go down and kind of squeeze it in right here. This is 4 plus and minus 2i root 6. And again, that's why the I lives there, because this was something other than 1. And then I'm going to look to see, is this reducible here? And it is. So I'm going to just break this into a fraction just to show it to you, that I can assign the 4 to that, just rewrite it by itself, plus and minus all by itself, and take the 4 and assign it over here. And I can kind of think about reducing it this way if you can't do it mentally. Okay? So I have 4 fourths, which is 1, plus or minus. And then here, I have 2 fourths, which is 1 half. So this becomes, and see, because now it's going to be a 1 over here, I get root 6i over 2. And that's the reduced form of that. Okay, so there are several examples of the quadratic formula. Again, just stay organized and try not to do too much at once, and it kind of works itself out very nicely. Okay? Good job.